keeping them honest every night. AC360, CNN, weeknights 10 Eastern.
Tonight on The Ridiculous, I hope you're going to watch this Ridiculous because I think it's funny. Tonight on The Ridiculous, a repeat appearance and new developments from a man named William Tapley. Or as he's also known, I always mess that part up. William, what are you also known as?
Also known as the third eagle of the apocalypse and the co-prophet of the end times.
That's right. That is right. I always confuse him with the second eagle of the apocalypse or the vice prophet of the end times. Anyway, for those of you who don't subscribe to William's YouTube channel, we put him on The Ridiculous last week because he has a problem with the Denver International Airport. That's right, the Denver International Airport. Now, I know a lot of people have gripes with airports. I get that. Unfortunately, the lock on Eagle Eye's overhead bin appears to be just a little bit loose.
This program is a continuation of my series on the Denver International Airport, and especially the murals and the art contained therein. Because they are evil, they are signs of Satanism, and on this program I will point out that many of them are phallic symbols.
Oh, make yourself comfortable, folks, because he's just getting going. This guy sees phalluses more than Anthony Weiner's female Twitter followers.
Now, in previous videos, I have pointed out that this is actually the figure of a naked woman, and the crotch is formed by a bird form. But right opposite the woman is a penguin, and a YouTuber pointed out to me that this sign on the penguin's cage constitutes a phallic symbol, and in fact represents the male genitalia.
Damn those YouTubers, not to mention those pesky penguins and their genitalia. Anyway, William is upset with us because he says we were making fun of him. But for the record, I don't like to think I ever make fun of anyone on The Ridiculous. I like to think I'm having fun with you. Anyway, the one-winged dove of the rapture doesn't quite see it that way.
Now, wait a minute, Mr. Anderson Cooper.
Yeah, that's never a good start.
It's really not that funny, Mr. Cooper.
Actually, it is. But preach it to me, brother.
Okay, so let me spell it out for you, Mr. Cooper. Or in this case, let me draw it out for you.
Oh, no. Please do not draw it out.
Now, if you had taken art class, Mr. Cooper, you would know that this is a female private part and this is a male private part.
I'm pretty sure you don't have to take an art class to know that. A quick trip to the bus station, you should be all set.
But I'm going to mark it for you so that you can see it very clearly. Now, let me assure you that Mr. Leo Tanguma is no Michelangelo. This is pornography. This is not art.
All right, first of all, I had no idea penguins have that big a package. Did you? I mean, how did they even waddle? Second of all, those of you watching should know that the man he mentioned, an artist named Leo Tanguma, well, we emailed him for comment. He didn't get back to us. And if not wanting to mix it up with the Commodore of the Armageddon isn't a sign of a true artist, I don't know what is. By the way, just for the sake of argument, I'm willing to let the reporter of the Rapture claim victory on the dirty, dirty penguin who's packing heat. But Third Eye Blind fails to back up any of his other numerous claims about hidden phalluses at the airport.
Many of the shapes on the horse's tail and mane are phallic shapes.
And by the way, whatever you do, do not get William the Conqueror started on the outdoor baggage handling area.
The outdoor baggage handling area is in the shape of a phallus. Up here we see the testicle area, and then out here the phallus.
Look, however William wants to handle his baggage, that's his business. I don't want an argument. I don't want to anger the fifth beetle of the Beelzebub any more than I already have. So what is it exactly we can do for you?
And so, Mr. Cooper, it is time for you to take me off your Ridiculous.
I'm going to go with no on that one. Sorry, Third Eagle of the Apocalypse and co-prophet of the end times. I mean you no harm, but you will always live long, and I do mean long, on the Ridiculous.